Good evening, everyone. Jake is going to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Regular action meeting on November 28th, 2022. Time is now 6:29 p.m. The New Jersey Open Meeting Law was enacted to ensure the right of the public to have advance notice of and to attend the meetings of public bodies at which any business affecting their interest is discussed or agreed upon. In accordance with the provision of this act, the Mattawan-Aberdeen Regional School District Board of Education advertised this meeting on June 7th, 2022 in the Asbury Park Press and the Star Ledger. This notice was sent to the municipal clerks of the borough of Mattawan and the township of Aberdeen and the Mattawan-Aberdeen Public Library. The notice was also placed on the district's website. Okay, so we're going to move forward. We're going to skip roll call and minutes and move on to the superintendent's report, which I'm going to pass over to Mr. Cronin.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you, President Scully. President Scully, Board of Education, Dr. Micah, Central Office Administration, parents and students. Thank you everyone for allowing us to host this Board of Education meeting tonight, and thank you for attending. Thank you to the students for all the hard work you've done with the multiple rehearsals. I've had a unique opportunity to transition into this role as the principal here at Ravine Drive well after the planning for this presentation began. So I was able to observe and watch our talented specialist teachers work with our third grade students as they plan this entire presentation. So over the next 10 to 12 minutes or so, you will see Mr. Levinson lead our third grade orchestra as they sing two songs. During the second song, you will see a video that Miss Airy and Miss Viola put together. During the video, you will see a dance that Miss Rose choreographed with our preschool students. Yes, I agree. So, you know, in the brief month that I've been here, I have been able to see firsthand why Ravine Drive has developed and earned the reputation that it has. And I'm so grateful to be able to work with the students and the staff, the parents and the community, and I look forward to being able to continue to partner with you as the traditions continue on and as we watch all of our students succeed and grow in the future. And with that, Mr. Levinson.
Well, good evening, everyone, families, and Board of Ed attendees. I am more than honored to welcome to the stage our talented and hardworking third grade performers. They were all volunteers. They all requested that they be part of this very special event. So without further ado, so you can hear their amazing performance for you all tonight, we have two songs for you. We're starting with Chicken Soup with Rice by Carol King.
February it will be. I have
All right, so to accompany our next song, there is a presentation to your right. It is a slideshow of various activities that have been going on so far this year at Ravine Drive. During that presentation, we will be singing the song "This Land Is Your Land" by Woody Guthrie. The parents of our third grade performers, you can meet your child in the library. That's where a drop off will be. Thank you. Sorry, pickup will be. Excuse me. Thank you.
Okay, Ms. Case, can we have roll call?
Mr. Ahern?
Here.
Ms. Vilas?
Here.
Ms. Friedman?
Here.
Ms. Martinez?
Here.
Mr. Montone?
Here.
Ms. Pell?
Here.
Ms. Osborne?
Present.
Mrs. Coley?
Here. Okay, can I get a motion and a second to approve the minutes? Committee of the Whole meeting minutes, October 3rd, 2022. Executive session meeting minutes, October 3rd, 2022. Regular action meeting minutes, October 17th, 2022. And executive session meeting minutes, October 17th, 2022.
So moved.
I'll second.
Roll call.
Mr. Ahern?
Yes.
Ms. Vilas?
Yes.
Ms. Friedman?
Yes.
Ms. Martinez?
Yes.
Mr. Montone? Ms. Powell?
Yes.
Ms. Osborne?
Yes.
Mrs. Scully?
Yes. Okay, we are going to proceed forward to the board president's report. First, I just wanted to say thank you. I know everybody, the parents already left to pick up their children, but I did want to say thank you to Mr. Levinson and Mr. Cronin, and especially the students, because watching them perform is amazing. It's one of the best parts of our job is to actually see the students perform. And they're all so talented and they're so cute and their voices are beautiful. And it takes me back because my own kids performed on this stage, seems like an eternity ago. So thank you. Hope everyone enjoyed their Thanksgiving break with family and friends. We wanted to start by thanking all the staff and school community members who have donated to MARSD Cares. Through your generous donations, we were able to deliver 125 meals to families in need within our district for the Thanksgiving holiday. And I really am so thankful, we all are, that we live in a district with such kind-hearted and giving community members. To be able to supply that many dinners is amazing. Also, you will see in tonight's agenda an agreement we reached between the Mattawan Regional Administrators Association and the MARSD Board of Education for the time period covering July 1st, 2023 through June 30th, 2026. Thank you to the MRAA Negotiations Committee and the Board Negotiation Committee for all your hard work. You worked together very efficiently and effectively, and it was over only several meetings in order to be able to negotiate a fair and equitable agreement for both sides. From the board standpoint, I wanted to thank Ms. Friedman for chairing the committee, Ms. Martinez, and Ms. Pell for all their contributions. And with that, we're going to move forward onto the rest of the agenda. We have curriculum and instruction. Ms. Perez?
Good evening. We're asking for board approval for items listed under on pages 1 and 2. That concludes curriculum and instruction.
Can I get a motion and a second to approve the agenda?
So moved.
I'll second.
Okay, student services, Ms. Perez.
Tonight we're asking for board approval on items listed under 1, 2, 3, and 4 on page 1, and item number 5 on page 2. That concludes student services.
Can I get a motion and a second to approve the agenda?
I'll motion. I'll second.
Okay, personnel, Mr. Liebman.
Thank you, good evening. We're gonna begin with a walk-in item. We're asking the board to approve the walk-in item for action. Item number 1 on the walk-in is a resignation, as listed. Item number 2 is an appointment, as listed. To the regular agenda, we're asking the board to approve items in red as listed for action in sections A, B, C 1 through 9, D 1 through 6. That concludes personnel.
Thank you. Can I get a motion and a second to approve the agenda?
I'll second.
Okay. Finance, Ms. Case?
We'll be taking actions on items 1 through 14 this evening.
Okay, can I get a motion and a second to approve the agenda?
I'll motion.
I'll second. Okay, any questions or comments from the board on agenda items?
I have a question.
Sure, Ms. Osborne.
I see here that we have a resignation from the nurse from Lloyd Road, and I didn't get a chance to ask you this question before, but isn't this the same nurse that we trained with Bruce, because Bruce is meeting this week? We have another.
We're going to speak about this executive session tonight.
Any other questions or comments from board members on agenda items? Okay. With that, then we will move to public comments on agenda items and additional matters. The Board of Education recognizes the value of public comment on matters of interest to the school community. Individuals wishing to speak must state their name and municipality of residence. Comments are limited to 3 minutes duration, but an individual may speak a second time after all others who wish to speak on the topic have been heard. All statements should be directed to the board president, and no participant may address or question board members individually. All speakers are requested to express themselves in a civil manner with due respect for the dignity and privacy of others whose legal rights may be affected. Please note, while it is not the board's intention to stifle comment on matters of legitimate concern, the public should be aware that if their statements violate the rights of others under the law of defamation or invasion of privacy, they may face personal liability to the injured party. If speakers are uncertain of the legal ramifications of their comments, the board urges them to seek guidance beforehand from their own legal advisor. Any public comments? Thank you for staying. Anyone else from the public? Okay. Then we are going to take action on the agenda items for curriculum and instruction, student services, personnel, and finance. Mr. Rayburn?
Yes, except I'm going to abstain on number 14 on the finance report.
So noted. Ms. Vilas?
Yes.
Ms. Friedman?
Yes.
Ms. Martinez?
Yes.
Mr. Montone?
Yes.
Ms. Pell?
Yes.
Ms. Osborne?
Yes.
Ms. Scully?
Yes. Okay, do we have any old business we want to address? Okay. Any new business? Ms. Friedman?
Thank you. So over the past 6 months, I have been giving a lot of thought to a number of things. Some of you may be aware that I just got finished with a very long trial. I'm going to take this opportunity to announce that at the beginning of this meeting, I handed letters to Dr. Micah, Mrs. Scully, and Ms. Case. I am resigning from the board at the conclusion of this meeting. I've been on this board for 8 years. I joined the board, ran for the board, when my daughter was having some issues with reading assignments that I didn't know about. I joined specifically and ran hard for the board seat because we were in the beginning stages of a superintendent search. One of the things that I will always be the most proud of as my work as a board member is being one of the people who hired Dr. Micah and took a chance on him. He has been amazing for this district, and as I would love to believe that my 8 years of serving here has been some sort of game changer, it is without a doubt the leadership that Dr. Micah has brought to this district and the administration he has brought to this district. There is nothing, aside from being a parent, that has given me as much pride. Not always easy, certainly for a couple of years being a member of the board, but it has always been the most meaningful experience I have had. And so I wanted to thank the community, I wanted to thank the board, and just to put flavor to this, I think when I started with the board, Mr. Cronin was still a science teacher somewhere. So to be leaving and have him be principal, to know that my daughter took her graduation photo with him, and I have my own selfie from my last Board of Education meeting as a board member with him, is just full circle. So again, I would like to thank everybody. I have to, I guess, add a date onto my letter, but I would ask for that to be effective as of the end of this meeting.
Ms. Friedman, thank you for your kind words. I'm humbled by them. However, please know that it's a team effort by everybody up here, and the decisions that we made collectively ultimately resulted in where we are today, and I have you to thank for that. I will always have a place in my heart for every board member and for the things that you did for our students and our community. We'll never go forgotten, because every day that I walk through the buildings, you know, it's a testament to the work that you did and the other 8 board members up here, not only right now, but those that have come and gone for the past 9 years. So I'm humbled by your words, and I thank you for them, but It's a team effort at the end of the day, and you were a part of that team, and I'm greatly appreciative of that. So thank you.
So, excuse me, Ms. Friedman, I want to sincerely thank you on behalf of the entire board for your dedication to not only the students, the staff, and school community, but also to all of us board members, because you've given a lot of guidance through the years. Over the 8 years that you've served on the board, you've served as board president, you've chaired numerous committees, volunteered for numerous committees, you've fought hard to get state funding for us, you've also fought to get us more funding for KEYS through the years, which we have successfully gotten, so thank you. Strategic planning, you've always been there, security committee, like every committee, I feel like you're always there, and you've given your all, and we will all miss having you sit on the dais with us and having your expertise and knowledge. And hopefully we still hear from you in the future and talk to you, because I consider you a friend, and I think others do here too. So thank you.
I appreciate the kind words. I figure now I'll just make my time at the superintendent's round table, which I'm not sure how well that's attended, but you know. And I am grateful for, again, the opportunities. I have been very proud of the work this board has done and how they work to understand and communicate with each other. I see we have some of our new board members in the audience. I wish them luck and hope that they continue in that spirit. And as to picking a new board member, ideally maybe they can all start at the same time and have a nice bond there.
Thank you. Anyone else? Okay.
with that,
Oh yes, sorry.
I forgot where we were with old business, new business. I just wanted to also piggyback about the MARSD CARES. I was able to help volunteer deliver some of the meals, so that was such a great experience. Haven't done anything like that in a little while, and I had told Ms. Perez that it was very humbling, and it was a nice reminder of what we have and what we don't have, and being appreciative. So it was a good day. So I just want to thank the district, because it was unbelievable how many families and how grateful they all were at the doors, even that I just went to 20 families, but. There was 100 and what did you say? 25. Yeah. So, anyway, it was a great thing, and I appreciate the district and all their help. Thank you, guys. Sure.
Anyone else? New business? Okay. With that, we move to executive session. Be it resolved that a closed session be convened for the purpose of discussing privacy, personnel, and attorney-client matters. The subject matter of these discussions will be disclosed to the public when the reason for confidentiality subsides. Although the board cannot guarantee it, the length of the executive session is estimated to be 15 minutes, after which the public meeting of the board shall reconvene and proceed with business. Action will not take place. Can I get a motion and a second to enter executive session?
So moved.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.